Alrighty. Hello, hello, hello. It's your boy, Otto the Tarantula, and it's Saturday, so that means another movie night is upon us. Tonight's movie is going to be Night of the Living Dead from 1968. It's the zombie movie that started it all, and I think it's pretty important. I think it's a pretty good one, too. It is a public domain movie, so it is quite easy to find online for free, and probably is on just about every streaming service too because of that as well. Like, you usually find it like bundled in a classic horrors DVDs or something like that. It's everywhere, and yet there's still a good amount of people who haven't seen it. So, it's quite the interesting conundrum. How did it get to public domain? I think the distributor just forgot to file for public, or not public, file for the copyright. So, literally, yeah, just a little slip up. Now it's public domain. So you can watch and share the movie for free. Oh man, this is definitely a good one to watch for this month. Well, I'm pretty excited. I hope everyone else is excited. Of course, what was it? I think there was also. Oh, no, never mind. I was thinking it was public domain because I think George Romero had a problem with executives or something, but that was more of they wanted him to add some things to the movie, and he was just like, nope. But it's funny to think this film is in black and white, although I'm pretty sure color was pretty common by this point. But it almost like is it's like the transition line from the cheesy B horror, the B movie horror, B okay, B movies that were horror, right? It was kind of like, oh God. It was kind of like the transition from the usual campy black and white, classic horror into modern horror with gore and all that. So it still has like that classic feel, but it's a lot more violent and gruesome compared to what you would see in black and white films. So it's pretty interesting choice. Alrighty. So how a watch along works is you'll have to find a movie, a movie. You'll have to find the movie on your own. I know it's public domain, but as much as I wanted to show it directly on stream, I think I would have to go through some channels on Twitch to make sure it's okay. And it's like, that might be a 1 to 2 week relay, so I'd rather not risk it and, also be super late with this showing. So yeah, I'm just gonna do it the classic watch along style, but again, this movie is pretty easy to find. So you just get your movie ready on your end. I will have the movie ready on my end. And when I say go, we'll both click play and we'll be watching the movie in sync. I also have a timer to help you keep track. I am watching this on Shudder. There's like, so it's like, there's not really any logos at all compared to other streaming services. The movie literally just starts. So it is quite nice. I don't know if that's the way it is for other streaming services. Maybe you got like a really quick 15-second or 30-second ad and then the movie starts or something to that degree. So if you don't have anything, then I'm basically starting at like a black screen. Because there's no logos, the movie literally will just go from black screen and then boom, you're gonna see like the black and white scene. So yeah, it's like 4 or 5 seconds of darkness and then movie. So I'm starting from the zero marker on that black screen, and hopefully that'll help you sync up. So we're gonna get ready to start the movie here. Alrighty. In 3, 2, 1, go. Boom, movie. I'm gonna make sure that the movie audio is not coming through. Thank God. Image 10 production was on the screen. We see the car going around, doing a sick drift. It's coming. And that car is coming. Night of the Living Dead. I look at that. Just a really simple font there. Screenplay by John Russo and George Romero. The man, the myth, the legend. I wish I could have remembered like all of the fun facts about this movie. But like I know too many that they kind of overwrote what I knew about this film. Other than George Romero not listening to executives and keeping the movie to the vision that he wanted. See, on that sign, it says cemetery entrance, like, because it's black and white, I can't tell if that's, like, mud or if that's blood. It's kind of interesting if it would be blood, though. Produced by Russell W. Strainer. Carl Hardman. Directed by George A. Romero. I forgot this movie is on a Sunday. Maybe I should have waited one more day to watch this. Get that real immersion. Oh, man, the radio had technical problems. You know, they could have said something important there. And that's always the fun part. Anyone else regularly go to a cemetery to visit? Graves of past loved ones. Because it's always quite the time to remember where they're buried. It's a good question. Well, I'm pretty sure they don't really take away whatever you put on the grave. I've seen plenty of dead flowers around graves. I do think that little detail is funny. But they were like, oh, you know, it's 8 and it's still light outside. And it's like, you know, I get the feeling it was, they just had to shoot during the day because no one wants to be in a cemetery at night. Got him. That's the line. Very famous line. The irony of that. Man saved her, at least. He's a good brother. Oh, look at them go. Boom. Yeah, that's right. No time to run with them shoes. Gotta kick them off. Get to the car. Leave your bro behind. I always find it interesting because, you see how quickly the zombie can move around the car and try to get at getting in, but then you'll see them walking. Okay, and that part is also something that I don't think I've seen other movies do really. You see he actually picked up a brick and smashed the window in, so it's like, these zombies can kind of think still. As opposed to the usual, they just keep hitting at a window until it smashes. Which begs the question of how strong are zombies? They always appear to be pretty strong because it's like their grip is really tight and then they can bash through a lot of things, but at the end of the day, it should be relatively weak, right? Because they're rotting. Their muscles don't work. The only thing that makes sense is the grip because of like rigor mortis, where you just clench up whatever, right? The body clenches up. Man. First house scene in like the middle of nowhere. She has now gotten into the house. The safest place to be right now. I like her coat. The only room where things look a little trashy. For some reason, all the other rooms look kind of clean, but this is the one room. Like, if they implied that, there was a zombie in this house, I'm sure a lot more would have been messed up. But there's only one room that's messed up, so, that's not a zombie, that's just Someone who knocked things over and was lazy. Searching around the house. Who are you gonna call? Nope. No phone. No phone lines. Hang on, we got cell phones and cell data now. Just in case of a zombie apocalypse. You notice though, he like turns around like almost immediately once those other zombies show up. But then like, he notices they are zombies, so then he stops caring. And ooh.
Phew.
Sorry. I tried to mute myself in time. It's like, these zombies seem to have a awareness on them. It's another survivor. She's too much in shock. That's something that you didn't see from movies too much at this time. Just the whole like face kind of rotted away. She's in hella shock. That blood is still dripping, man. It's like that kill was not too long ago then, yeah? How long does blood stay that runny? Take out the headlights. I hate the light. Definitely need to keep awareness about you, dude. Man, gotta get back into the house there quick, sir. There you go. See, and then this one kind of reels back in pain, and it's like, you would think zombies don't feel pain, so this was like, this really was the start where it's just like, man, it's stuff you never see really in any other zombie movies, because this is when they were just getting started, establishing all the rules. Look at him marching. Burn the body. And it seems like they're frightened away by the fire. Or maybe it's because of the light of the fire. See, she's so in shock, she almost seems like a zombie herself, just mind empty, stuck on fear. She keeps a knife around, but it's like, she's deaf. She hasn't seemed ready whenever they come around anyway, so. Lazy shows like the patience and understanding, you know. Like he was gonna yell, but it's like, all right, I see. You're scared too. It's gonna be okay. I mean, they're just, it's like a way of saying, like, you know, she is so scared that, like, her soul has already left her body. Music box. Now, he took out that door pretty quickly. In general, this man is moving very quickly. Man's carrying this team. There you go, Barbara. Got some wood. She has achieved the quest. There you go. Now she's a team player. I wonder if there's classification for like different levels of shock, because she's like, what? Maybe like level 8 of shockness. I do fear the fire. Fire bad. That I would probably carry, like, you know, a torch or something. That would probably be the ideal weapon if they're afraid of fire, you know. Still hear those lambs, Clarice? If you see, like, she is quite the hysteria, I think that's what you'd call it. Like, her story isn't even correct to what happened. That was definitely a moment of, snap out of it. My question is, did he hit her so hard that she fainted? Did she faint because of exhaustion, you know? I think it's the exhaustion just because of how delayed it was. Funky looking radio there. See, some say ordinary, some say they look like they're in a trance. And they cut off like the third description. I'm sure the description would be, maybe they look dead. But I think it's cool that they cut off the third description. The motivation of this man, with the way he moves, it's like, you'd almost think this was not his first rodeo of dealing with the undead. Like, he is just thinking on his feet really well. Those are the people that, probably gonna last the longest in a situation like this. There we go. Now he's making a torch. They hate it. They hate fire. Why are we zooming in on that door? out of the doors now. They do make the best barricades. When in doubt, gotta take the time to smoke, I guess. There you go. Things that look like people but act like animals. Now that is a chilling description. Gotta find the ammo there. Got some shoes for her now. Yeah, that's us. Staying safe. Boarding up houses. That was for. That mark on her cheek wasn't there when she was laying down. Might have just been the angle, though. Also, her shoes disappeared. Man's put shoes on her, and then they're just gone in the next shot. Little continuity error there. Gotta do something about that body. It's clever because it's like they tried to hide it. They tried to hide the face. You can see it there for a second though, and it's definitely nothing like it showed up earlier. There you go. Flesh-eating zombies. more survivors. Origins, right? The human drama. Moral dilemmas. It is hurt, huh? Good points. Only one way in and one way out. You know, it's like during a zombie apocalypse, maybe it's ideal. But it's true, if they come through that one way, you're screwed. The whole house. Yep. If you stay up there, it's like multiple entryways, but also exits. You could run away. Oh. Man. Shot him like basically in the heart. He's still standing. They're doing a good job at keeping that gun away from their heads, that's for sure. Boom. See, now no one has to repeat the info. You got the info right there. But, man. Even the nudity levels, I don't think it's something you saw. 68? I don't know. I don't think there was like a rating system, right? I don't think there was a rating system then. She's eating a bug. Man, just roasting him. Oh, there we go. The division between the cellar and the living area. Living area upstairs. She's kind of a vegetable, so. Maybe it would have been better for her to go down in the cellar, you know? Otherwise, she's just an extra mouth to feed right now. Man's just so angry. That wife has kind of got the right mindset, you know. It's like it's being right or wrong is not important. Trying to stay alive is the important thing, you know. There you go. See, she's got the right idea. You may not like each other, but dying together is no good. All these what is it, compromises. Just work together, people. There's the Seems to be a wound on her arm. Uh-oh. She says she felt warm, so, probably just a scratch. Nothing to worry about. Just a little shock. Like, yep, our girl Barbara here. She's still in a big time shock, man. Yep. Everyone's got a smoke in this movie. Yeah, it's so interesting though. It's like, they said the description earlier, they look like people but they act like animals, and it's like, she's basically a zombie. She's just living, but like she's reacting to the fire too. She's just going based on what she senses right now. At first, people didn't believe it. Unburied dead. So not even like if you're in the grave, you're not coming back. But if you died on land, then you seem to be a zombie. Look at that, they got multiple headquarters set up. There you go. Radiation. A logical explanation. The military guy is a little skeptical, like maybe it's the radiation. They're not sure. But radiation is the only thing that makes sense. But man, in this one movie, you know, we got all the rules established, right? Even back then, man, paparazzi never stopped being the paparazzi. And I know everyone would definitely want to know in that situation. But it's like, you know, you kind of let gotta let the people go to do their job so they can find out. Makes a point, how is everyone gonna fit into that truck, you know? At least he's letting the mom stay with the kid, you know. See, all the limbs were gone, but the head was still trying to get a bite to eat. Only a few minutes to act, man. I gotta make more torches, perhaps. See, they're coming together now. He's got the truck. All right, so there we go. Step one, get out to the truck and fuel it up. Then step two is going to be getting everyone onto the truck somehow. Question is, can they really pull it off? Because they're leaving the stingy man to cover their asses with the Molotovs. I wonder, would anyone stay? If the place is safe for the moment, would you stay there or would you try to go out for their rescue headquarters? Either way is risky, you know. Cover your eyes, everyone. Can't be showing people kissing. That's inappropriate. There you go, Barbara. Man, she is just gone ever since that slap. I mean, even before then. And they're clearing those boards pretty fast. The long stare. This girl's just worried. There you go, Mr. Cooper. Again on that Molotov duty. Get you some kills, Mr. Cooper. Away, beasts. Man, I'd be nervous about accidentally hitting the truck. We managed to get one of them, though. All right, making a play. It's in the truck. Go, go. She should have made up her mind like way earlier when they were planning. Fear the torch. Yeah, that's what I would try to do too. I would try to stab at them with the fire. So once they're set on fire, you know, they kind of like run away. See, I thought the truck was out of gas. So how are they like managing this right now? Even get to the pump, you know? Or maybe he just left barely enough just for this then. Well, he panicked. He can get the key. Panicked with the key. He panicked with the gasoline. Uh-oh. My truck's on fire. There's gasoline around. Oh, her jacket's stuck. Get out of there. Oh, shit. That would like really suck, man. Because it's like, that was your method of getting out. Not only did you lose your method of getting out, you lost like, two people that you got to know as well. Just use the torch, my guy. Yeah, that would be like method number two that I think could work okay. Is like, what if everyone got a torch and like moved in a circle, covering each other's backs? But given that it's night, it'd be hard to see anything coming in. Oh. Unlock the door, Mr. Cooper. He was just scared, but like, he's helping, at least. Like, if I saw that too, I would probably think, okay, you know what? Anyone who's outside might be screwed, so maybe it is best to lock the door. Ooh. Those punches, though. But it's like, I mean, I don't know. I don't think you can be too angry at him in that situation. Man saw the people explode too, so like, he's a little in shock as well. You can't be too hard on Mr. Cooper there. Yeah, look at that. They're taking the pieces. Must be quite the barbecue. Got the intestines there. It's like liver. Man, the faces on these zombies though tells you like, man, did these actors really have to eat like, some like raw shit on camera? Because it's like no one seems to be enjoying the eating. I mean, obviously not like swallow, but like, they still have to chew it, right? So. She was bitten. The man's like playing with those intestines. Wonder what this was like, when this came out. I really do. And all the other horror movies that would soon follow. What was it like when this stuff was like new and original? There you go, the headshot. Aim for the brain. Oh yeah, they call them ghouls in this movie. Eat 'em or burn 'em. Oh, power's gone. Oh, Mr. Cooper's losing it now, too. Rock. Wayne. See, they know how to use tools. That's pretty creepy. Trying. They had power for so long. I'm wondering what could have cut it off, you know? Because, like, for that area, it seems like things were relatively under control. They still had the radio line and the TV. Once that gun. So much fighting amongst themselves in this situation, it's like. Oh man. He shot Mr. Cooper. See, you know that if you kill something, it comes back as a zombie, so like both of them pointing the gun at each other was not good. But man, you can already see like the bags under his eyes now. He looks really pale. Like it's like he's already transforming, even though he's not dead. He's dying. There's a zombie from the cemetery. There you go. Barbara's finally out of it. She's getting in there helping. Oh. She ate his arm. Daughter's a zombie. Snap out of it, woman. You gotta get up. How it sucked. Those things aren't even that sh sharp, so like to be stabbed with them, that's gonna be painful. See, and they know how to use tools. Only two people are alive now. It's Johnny. Goodbye, Barbara. Here comes the graveyard man. Behind you. Oh, he caught it. He got that counter. He just threw her. Don't really got the time to kill. Now they've officially broken into the house, man. Only one way in, one way out. And with all of them pressing against it, it's still holding fine. So, you know, that means that, hey, I guess the seller was the best option. Spawn killing. Headshot, dude. He was gone already. You didn't need to use the other two bullets. You gotta save him. One bullet for her, three for Mr. Cooper. They're losing interest. Oh. Now it, the night is over. The morning has come. The light at the end of the tunnel. That a helicopter should attract all the attention with how much noise it's generating, you know? Look at those good boys. You can just have coffee. Dogs. They're still shooting with one hand. It's like they get in the position, but they still shoot with the one hand. Gotta put two on a pistol, you know? one after another. Those guys have definitely had quite the night, that's for sure. Just going through town and killing them all. It's good that they've stayed awake, but like, don't want anyone drowsy on a gun, you know? Or for the dismemberment. Yeah, there's the credits. Jeez. That ending, I still remember it. Like, I didn't really remember. I knew that everyone died, I just didn't remember how. But the ending, I still remember, and it's still effective. Like, holy shit, dude. Look at that. See, I think the mistake there was, you know, he should have said, "Hey, you know, I'm alive. Is someone out there?" But because he stayed quiet and approached the window, you know, they couldn't clearly see him that he wasn't a zombie, so they shot him. It's like, damn, dude, so close to rescue, and it kind of goes to show too. If they had stayed in the cellar and waited, they would have all been safe, with the exception that, you know, they would have to deal with the little girl. Special thanks to WICTV. Burning the bodies. And the fact that he was thrown in at the end. Man, what a movie. What a movie. Oh, I need to stop the timer here. But man, like, this movie still holds up really well. It is so good. And it's like, it's no surprise that it spawned, you know, this genre. It's no surprise at all. It is chilling, you know, you got the descriptions of the zombies that are really good. You got like the suspense, you got the human drama, like where everyone could have worked together, but everyone was bickering and everyone died. Man, is it good though. It's so good. Maybe someday I'll get around to watching the sequels. I've only ever seen this one and Return of the Living Dead, but that one's not really related to this series. That's its own thing, surprisingly enough. Oh, man. And I think there was a remake of this, so maybe I'll have to check that out, see how it holds up compared. Man, such a good movie. I never get over that ending. Like, it's just like so close, man. We're so close. But no. Oh, that was fun. I quite enjoy movies. I think the world of VTubing needs more watch-alongs, so if I can add to that number, I am pretty grateful there. And if anyone stopped in the watch-along, maybe lurked in the shadows or anything, you're a real one. just listening to me ramble about how fun of a time it is watching a movie. Oh man. Damn, that ending though. It's like it sticks with you. It really sticks with you. Was a hell of a time though. And for 1968. Again, I'm really curious about the time frame there. If something like this, you know, if something this kind of brutal had been made before. I'll have to look into that. But thank you. Thank you for joining me on this nice night of the Living Dead watch along. Average movie length, but definitely not your average movie. Always, I hope everyone has a good night. Take care. Thank you. Thank you. And bye bye.